The ambulance union says lives could have been saved if more Victorians were seen by GPs, leaving paramedics for emergencies. As Penelope Leish reports, there are demands for a health funding overhaul to offer patients more options, particularly after hours.
Paramedics under the pump, busy responding to minor incidents when they could be saving lives.
There's no question that we have patients who have passed away that probably could have been saved had paramedics been available to respond.
The union says a shortage of doctors is piling on the pressure.
We've got patients going into cardiac arrest in the community and our paramedics can't respond, often because they're tied up at quite low acuity cases that could be very well treated by a GP.
The Royal Australian College of General Practitioners says there is a shortage and work needs to be done to attract more doctors, as well as changes to funding to spread the load.
A long-term lack of investment in general practice, the federated model of funding in health no longer makes as much sense as it used to.
The Northern Hospital has been running a virtual emergency department for non-life-threatening emergencies. The ambulance union says services like this, giving patients more options, are vital.
It frees them up so they can then go and respond to another, often more time-critical case. Super clinics are also another fantastic option.
It comes as the opposition accuses the government of hiding a report into the Emergency Services Telecommunications Authority after a parliamentary order to produce key documents expired.
A dozen Victorians have died waiting for an ambulance. The report's been given to the Premier to fix it and he hasn't bothered to read it.
A letter from the Acting Attorney-General revealing the government is in the process of collating and considering the relevant documents and will endeavour to provide a final response as soon as possible.
While they're playing politics, I've spent a good portion of this week talking to paramedics.
Penelope Leish, Nine News.